We are working with 9709/32, October, November 17. In this question, we have been asked to use the trapezium rule to find the area or to approximate the area. The condition which we are imposed are that we have to use two intervals. What does that mean? It means that we have to divide this figure, we have to divide this whole figure into two equal chunks. This would be this thing, that thing, and that thing. Okay? So now, having divided dividing our figure into two equal parts, now we are going to imply the trapezium rule. So before starting the trapezium rule, a brief intro for the formula for finding the, for working out with the trapezium rule. The area for the figure would be equal to half into width of the interval multiplied by height number 1 plus twice of height number 2 plus height number 3. So what is height number 1, height number 2, height number 3? This one is, let's say I have labeled it as H3. This one is H2 and this one is over H1. Okay, now we have to first find the value of the heights. Since we are given this equation, we are going to put the value of the variables in this equation to find the value of x. Since for H1, let's say for H1, we have to work with 3 divided by square root of 9 minus 1.2 cube. It turns out to be 1.2 times 1.2 times 1.2. It is 1.728. 1.2 into 1.2 into 1.2 plus 9. 10.728. Square root of the number. This is 3. This becomes 3/3.275. 7.5. So what we are left with? 3/3.275. This is 0.916. So H3 is this, and we have to find H2 as well. H2 is equals to, we have to put 0, so the square root of the cube is 0, 3, 3 square root is 9. 3.3, that becomes 1. So we have we found all the values. Now the next thing is the width of the interval. The width of the interval, this width. This width is that w. Or that w. Usually these w's always remain the same. It should remain the same. If you're not, if you're not getting the same value of w, then you are working in the wrong way. So now we are going to find the formula. So apply the formula. So area would be half times W, that is 1.2, into H1. H1 was 0.916 plus. Let me check the formula. Plus twice of H2. That would be 2 into 1. That would be 2. Plus 1.112. So this is our complete solution. Okay, now we have to do just the calculations thing. Okay, so 0.916 added to 2 plus 1.112. This got to be multiplied by 1.2 and got to be divided by 2. So your answer will be 2.416. So area is 2.416. Okay, in this question we are asked that why trapezium rule may give us better results. So if we look at our figure, this is something like that. sorry, something like that. That's all. So the answer for the question is the change in height is not that much fluctuating, or height of trapezium is not varying. So our approximation is okay. Now if we ask if the height is varying, then what we overstep? We can decrease our width. The width we have taken over here is 1.2. If the height is very fluctuating or changing, then we can decrease our width. It may be asked at time, but one should know that if the height is changing, so we decrease our width. So this was a tip. You should remember that as well. Okay. In this question, we are given with a logarithmic equation, and we need to solve this as well. So, if I rewrite it, this would be 2 log to the base 2 of x is equals to 3 plus log to the base 2 of x plus 1. Okay. Now, what I would do is I would take the log on one side, all the operation in log to one side, and then solve my question. So, this is at coefficient of log, we can take it to its power. So this would become log to the base 2 of x squared. If this equation comes over here, that would become minus log to the base 2 of x plus 1, that is equals to 3. Now the logs are being subtracted, we can use the log property of division. Log to the base 2 of x squared divided by x plus 1, that would be equal to 3. We can change the log as well, or take an antilog of the base 2. After taking the antilog of the base 2, this would become x squared upon x plus 1, and this would become, since base was 2, so its antilog would be 2 raised to the power of 3. So that would be equal to 8. The next thing is just a simple quadratic equation. So x squared is equals to 8x plus 1, sorry, 8. So x squared minus 8x minus 8 is equals to 0. Now the x would be, x is equals to minus b, 8 plus minus under root b square minus 4ac, 64 minus 32 upon 2. So that would become, this I have space for here, 8 plus minus square root of 32 upon 2. Be 8 plus minus 4 under root 2 upon 2, that would be 4 plus 2 under root 2, that's the answer. Okay, in this question we are given with a trigonometric equation, and we need to solve this equation. So, for solving this equation, we are going to use trigonometric identity for sum of angle of tangent. That would become tan of A plus tan of B divided by 1 minus tan A tan B. So if the signs are switched, for example, if we got minus over here, this plus would shift it to minus and this would become plus. Other things are quite easy. Now we have to find the value of tan of theta, tan theta plus 60. So, and tan theta minus 60. So this would become tan theta minus tan of 60 upon 1 minus tan theta tan 60 plus tan theta. Okay, this was a little bit wrong. So take the plus sign. Tan theta minus tan of 60 degree divided by 1 plus tan theta tan 60. This would be equal to cot theta, which is 1 over tan theta again. Now tan of 60 degree is, I think so, under root 3. 60 tan. That is under root 3, yeah, under root 3. So the equation would be tan theta plus under root 3 divided by 1 minus under root 3 tan theta plus tan theta minus under root 3 divided by 1 plus square root 3 tan theta is equal to 1 over tan theta. Is equal to tan inverse of 1 over 11 and tan inverse of minus 1 over 11 square root and square root here as well. So this is our solution for this problem. I don't have the calculator, so I'm showing the calculator, so this is our solution.